Ricky Kareem for British Boxers. We're down here at Collier & Moston Boxing Gym today to find out what the lads think about a big fight coming up. Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder, two, who they picking?
Right, Zelfa, Brown, Flash, Barrett. Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder, two. How does the fight go and why?
Fury, you know, boxing. I just think he knew what he'd done last time and it was a great performance. So I just think now he'll just redo it but do it better.
And have you seen that debate that they've had on BT Sport with John Fury and...
I've not watched it, I've seen it on Facebook, all over Facebook.
One of the things they talked about was that Wilder, he's got to get better than the last fight, because last fight he was terrible.
Mm-hmm.
So if he makes the improvements, do you see that balancing anything out?
No, because Fury is one of the best boxers in the world. No matter if he's a heavyweight or not, his boxing ability is different. So I don't think that a better Wilder would make a better Fury. And against Ortiz, he'd give anybody else Ortiz. His style, just the way he throws. So I honestly believe that no matter how good Wilder is, I just still think that Fury will win.
Okay, well, what do you make of this talk of Tyson saying he's going for the knockout this time round? You think that's a smart strategy against someone like Wilder?
Maybe. Could it fire with fire? You know, you gotta take a risk for like great things to happen. So you know, he's got it in the bag, he knows what he's doing anyway, he's very smart. You know, he's a great boxer, so you know, he might even go for the knockout. He's a big guy, he only takes one punch. You know, we all know what with Wilder. Like he says, he just, if fighters can switch on with him for 12 rounds, he just needs to switch on and he can catch up, put you to sleep. So, you know, whatever plan he has, it'll work.
Okay, final prediction, points or stoppage then for Tyson?
Points. I just think a nice, no, I wouldn't say easy because no fight's easy, but a nice simple points win.
Alright, appreciate yourself. Cheers, man.
Respect. What saying?
Right, Fury Wilder 2.
Ooh.
How does the fight go and why?
I think Fury again.
Yeah?
Yeah, changed trainers, hasn't he? But I don't think he's going to let him. I think Fury's probably going to put a little bit more pressure on him, so he's not going to want to get put down again. But, you know, Fury were out for 2 years, weren't he, when they last fought, so
yeah.
I think he's just going to be another beast this time round.
Right, so you're going for point stoppage, how you see it?
I think it'll be points with Fury. He's saying that he wants to put it on him, doesn't he, but I think it's just a bit of mind games with him that. I don't think he's actually going to go for a knockout, is he? If he does, I think that's when he's going to get caught, if he does try to put it on him. But maybe he'll try to put it on him a bit more, so, you know, Wilder isn't as, you know, as easy at coming forward. So he's not going to want to get knocked down again, is he though?
No.
So we'll see.
Alright, so Fury points, that goes, everyone's saying Fury points.
Are they?
Yeah, pretty much. Not had anyone pick Wilder yet, so no. I'll keep asking, but yeah.
We'll
all right,
see.
Nice
yeah.
one mate.
Nice one. Cheers.
Right, we've got Kid Dynamite here, Mark Efron. Mark, Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder 2. How does the fight go and why?
See Tyson Fury winning it on points. I think if Deontay was going to beat him, it would have been in the first fight as Tyson had a lot of time out and lost all that weight. But yeah, I think Tyson's going to be a lot better in this one. I think Tyson does it on points, yeah.
Right, Ruthless Ryan Doyle. Fury Wilder 2 coming up. Who wins, why?
Fury for me, I think the first time round he outboxed him. Obviously he had the ring rust, but I think he's improved since then. 100% think he's going to beat Wilder.
You think it's going to be straightforward? Are they going to have some thrills and spills? How do you think it's going to pan out in terms of the fight?
It's a Tyson fight, so yeah, there'll be some thrills and spills in it, definitely. But personally, I think Tyson was outboxing, probably tie him up. Number five and beat my points.
Right, Lyndon, I know you're watching the sparring, but I've got to get your take on this big fight coming up. Fury Wilder 2, how does the fight go and why?
I think Fury is going to out. Sorry, the sparring's getting tasty.
It's getting tasty, yeah.
Yeah, I think the Fury's gonna outbox him. I think he's just gonna box his head off. I think he's just gonna box his head off.
He's gonna be more convincing than last time.
Yeah. I thought last time was convincing enough to win, but obviously the knockdowns made it controversial and whatnot. Yeah, I just think now because just like everyone's saying really, he's a lot more active. Well, he's been more active in the past time. He's got, you know, he's had a good few fights. He had a tough fight with Otto Wallin, even though he wasn't supposed to be a tough fight. Give him a tough fight, so he's been in there for a good grueling 12 rounds or whatever it was. I think he's going to be a little bit sharper, probably be a touch lighter. He's probably had better sparring, you know, he's probably had a better camp. Say he's going to come in there to knock him out, I don't think. That's just to get him wilder there, I believe. You know, it'd be fun to see him knock him out, but we'll see. But I'm Fury all the way.
Deontay Wilder ain't no Walter Wallen, is he?
No, he's not. But at the same time, he's not. He's only got, like, he's probably, like, it's mad that I'll say this, but Walter Wallen's probably better than Deontay Wilder in some certain aspects. You know what I mean? Because Deontay Wilder's got that one punch that can switch you off completely. But it's predictable, it's like, it's kind of like you can see it coming kind of thing, and with the boxing ability that Tyson Fury's got, I believe he'll see it coming a lot of the time. And he better get out. We've seen Tyson Fury get out of the way of, we know what elusive he is, getting out of way of punches and stuff, and with Deontay Wilder being as predictable as he is. You've seen him in Luis Ortiz fight. His box is like, it's, and it gets this off. So, and Luis Ortiz is nowhere near good a mover as Tyson Fury. He's very good, but he's nowhere near good a mover and getting away punches at Tyson. So, I just think he'll be able to get out of the way of the right hand and stick to our boxing like he did last time.
Alright, Tyson Fury on point.
Yeah.
Cheers, Lyndon. Right, Mr. Steve Naylor, big fight coming up. Wilder Fury 2, who wins and why?
Gonna go Fury. I just think he's been more active since the last fight. Last fight, I thought it was outboxing him. I know he got dropped a couple of times, but that made it a bit closer on the scorecards. It was a great fight, but I don't think he's gonna make the same mistakes he did in the first fight.
He's talking about knocking Wilder out in the second round. What do you make of that?
I just think it's a bit of talk. It helps sell the fight again. The fans probably, the neutrals will want to see something a bit different. Maybe Fury trying to go be a bit more explosive, but he's been a boxer since the day he first ever put on the gloves, and he's one of the best boxers ever to do it, so I think he'll be sticking to the boxing, and I think Wilder will struggle to lay a glove on him.
So you're going for Fury points?
Fury points, yeah.
Cheers, Steve. Right, Rob. Wilder Fury 2, how does the fight go and why?
I just think Fury's going to be too much this time for him. I just think he's going to completely outbox him, put that extra weight on as well. I think you're going to see a little bit more power, and I think he's going to take a few more risks as well. But again, you know, he's got to be switched on throughout the fight, switch off once for that Wilder. He's shown before now that, you know, he can end the fight with one punch. But I just think, for me, Fury too much for him this time round.
He had added weight and the power. Are you leaning towards the top then, or do you think it'd be points?
I mean, it depends how he approaches it, but like I said, he's had a little bit more time, you know, to prepare for it. With the added weight, I think, what's Wilder, 15 stone summit, Fury's going to come in around that 18 stone summit. You know, the added weight advantage, I think he could play a big factor. And it's not only the weight advantage, Tyson moves, he boxes, moves, you know, he carries the weight, you know, really effectively. So, I mean, we won't know till the night how effective he is with the extra weight on him. But I just think he'll outbox him, be able to smother his work, and I think he'll be victorious on the night.
Alright, cheers, Rob.
Sam, mate.
Right, Connor, Fury Wilder 2. How's the fight going, why?
I think probably Fury on points, to be fair. Obviously, last time he went on points anyway, but obviously, Wilder's obviously got the chance of the knockout, but I think he might have, like, Fury might have brushed up on last time on the mistakes he made, so I think the decision might be different this time.
Yeah? In terms of the fight, you think it's a distance fight?
Yeah. Yeah, it's going to be Fury on points, and it's what he's saying about the second round knockout is kind of like, he's probably just doing it for his own confidence and his own, do you know what I mean? It might be mind games, but can't really see him doing it in the second round. If he does, obviously, that's off to him, but in my opinion, it's probably going to be Fury points.
How big of an achievement would it be if Tyson, you know, coming back from what he's come back from and what happened in the first fight, how big of an achievement would it be for him to be walking away with the WBC belt?
Yeah, it's the biggest comeback in boxing, isn't it, really, in my opinion, anyway, but since I've been alive, but So nah, it's an amazing achievement anyway, definitely, 100%.
Yeah. Alright man, Fury points, cheers man.
Mr. Marcus Morrison, aka Sweet Eminem.
Sweet Eminem.
Wilder Fury 2, how do you see this fight going and why, mate?
Fury points. No, I'm hearing he's trying to get the knockout this time around, but I can't see it coming. I give him a comfortable points win, although, you know, as always with Wilder, it could come at any time, first, second, 12th, but I'm going to go with a Fury points win, wide, again.
Now obviously we're all Manchester based, we all, you know, some of the Doug Tyson, etc, so we're all behind him and stuff, but everyone in the gym has gone for Fury on points. But you know, I suppose if you're in an American gym, a lot more people would go for Wilder, wouldn't they, I suppose?
Well, the only thing you can count on with Wilder is that he'll carry the punching power, and that's the only thing, you know, you could put him with anyone, you know, any fight in the world, and you could say, because he's not actually the greatest boxer, he's really not. Ortiz, he was getting outboxed, even with the knockdown in the last fight, I had it still wide to Tyson. So it's just that, you know, he carries the dynamite in the right hand, but against anyone with Fury, I'd have him down to beat him on points. You know, I don't think he's a huge puncher, concussive puncher, and I don't think Wilder's the type to jack it and, you know, stay down if he gets put down. But I just think, you know, Fury's a technically a lot better boxer and, you know, can make it easy for himself to fight.
What do you make of the judge leaving it to the judges though? You know, obviously we've seen what happened last time. I think most people thought Tyson won the fight.
Yeah.
Can he win on points, you know, against
Look, the way I see it, if I was judging that fight, that last fight, it was still clear for me to see that Fury, you know, won the fight. And like I said before, he's apparently looking to go out there and, you know, he's working his right hand to chin him. And I just can't see it happening. I don't want Tyson to go out there looking for it and, you know, get clipped, you know, early on in the fight, because I think, you know, if it was early on in the fight where he got put down, I think he could have come out, you know, a different story, and Wilder would have, you know, put it on him proper. And I don't know if he'd have made it through, but, you know, I'd rather him not, you know, go and sort of try and have a tear up and try and chin him. I'd rather him go out there and just, you know, make comfortable for himself and outbox him. And, you know, I think giving the knockdown as well, I think that swayed the judges in the last fight. Whereas if the knockdown didn't happen, like, it'd be impossible to give it a draw. So I think Tyson should go out there and just stick to what he does and box.
I wore his best tracksuit.
Yeah? You wore your best tracksuit, yeah? You knew he was going to be on camera?
For British boxers, man. What is it? What's the saying now? Is it Paul?
I haven't said it for 2 years now, but I'll bring it back today. Right, talk to me about Wilder Fury 2.
No, there's nothing much to say, man. It's the Fury win. Maybe late knockout, but if not, probably points in it. I say points, but definitely Fury win.
Yeah, why are you so confident?
Oh, I used to spar with him back in the day. And I just know for the travellers and all that, yeah, he's going to do it for us. So I'm saying Fury.
Yeah, so you're saying Fury for the travellers, yeah?
Just cut it from there, no, that's all I got to say, nothing long.